Ayushi Verma from Investor Learn Academy, and I welcome you all to this channel. In the last video, we understood the profitability ratios. Today, we will talk about the second category of financial ratio, that is the leverage ratios. Leverage ratios are a key component of the financial analysis, which helps in determining whether a company has a sufficient cash flow to manage the debt obligations that are due. Leverage ratios are also known as the solvency ratios. These ratios are used by the lenders to determine the solvency state of the business. Companies that have a higher solvency ratio are deemed more likely to meet the debt obligations, while the companies with a lower solvency ratios are more likely to pose a risk for the banks and the creditors. Solvency ratios vary with different industries. Usually, a solvency ratio of 0.5 is usually considered as a good number to have. If a company has a low solvency ratio, it is more at a risk of not being able to fulfill its debt obligation and is likely to default the debt-free payment. Solvency ratio should not be confused with the liquidity ratio. Both are totally different. Liquidity ratios determine the capability of a business to manage its short-term liabilities, while the solvency ratios are used to measure a company's ability to pay the long-term debts. The formula for calculating the solvency ratios is as follows, where we can see the net income plus depreciation divided by the all liabilities. Now let's understand the types of solvency ratios. There are six types of solvency ratios which we will be covering in this video. First, debt to equity ratio. Second, debt ratio. Third, equity ratio. Fourth, interest coverage ratio. Fifth, debt to asset ratio. Sixth, financial leverage ratio. Now let's understand these six ratios in detail. First, debt to equity ratio. It's an important ratio which is used to evaluate a company's financial leverage. It measures the amount of total debt capital with respect to the total equity capital. This ratio helps understand if the shareholder's equity has the ability to cover all the debts in case the business is experiencing a bad time. It is also represented as D divided by E ratio and is calculated with the following formula, where we can see that long-term debt is divided by the shareholder's funds. The second way of calculating debt to equity ratio is the total liabilities divided by the shareholder's equity. A value of 1 in this ratio indicates an equal amount of debt and equity capital. Higher the debt to equity ratio, if it is more than 1, it indicates the higher leverage and hence one needs to be careful. Lower than 1 indicates a relatively bigger equity base with respect to the debt. Now the second ratio is the debt ratio. Debt ratio is used in measuring a company's financial leverage and it is calculated by taking the total liabilities in the form of long-term liabilities like bank loans, bonds payable, notes payable, etc. and dividing it with the total capital. If the debt ratio is higher, it represents the company is riskier. It is calculated with the following formula where we can see the long-term debt divided by the capital, or the second way of calculating it is long-term debt divided by the net assets. Low debt to capital ratio is indicative of a business that is stable, with a higher ratio shows doubt about a firm's long-term stability. Third, equity ratio. Equity ratio is also known as the proprietary ratio. It establishes a relationship between the proprietor's funds, that is the shareholder's fund, and the net assets or the capital. It is expressed as following, where we can see that the shareholder's funds divided by capital, or another way of calculating is the shareholder's fund divided by the total assets. Now the fourth ratio is the interest coverage ratio. The interest coverage ratio is used to determine whether the company is able to pay interest on the outstanding debt obligations. This ratio helps us interpret how easily a company can pay its interest payments. For example, if the company has the interest burden of 100 rupees versus an income of 400 rupees, then we can clearly say that the company has the sufficient funds to service its debt. The interest coverage ratio is also referred to as debt service ratio and debt service coverage ratio. The formula to calculate the interest coverage ratio is as follows, where we can see the earnings before interest and tax divided by the interest payment. The earning before interest and tax is calculated by EBITDA minus depreciation and amortization amount. The higher coverage ratio is better for the solvency of the business, while a lower coverage ratio indicates the debt burden on the business. Fifth, debt to asset ratio. This ratio helps us understand the asset financing pattern of the company. It conveys to us how much of the total assets are financed through the debt capital. The formula to calculate the same is as follows, where we can see that the total debt divided by the total assets. So for example, if it is 45% of the assets held by the company, which means it is financed through the debt capital or the creditors, and therefore the 55% is financed by the owners. Higher the percentage, the more leverage and risk it indicates. Sixth, financial leverage ratio. The financial leverage ratio gives us an indication to what extent the assets are supported by the equity. The formula to calculate the same is as follows, where we can see that the average total assets divided by the average total equity. Higher the number of this ratio, higher is the company's leverage. So in this video, we learned about the solvency ratios that determine the solvency of a business organization by measuring its ability to pay the long-term debt obligations. We'll meet you next week. Till then, be safe and happy learning.